Are you looking for local information regarding the Alpharetta, Georgia housing market? Well, that's what we're talking about today. And I'll share market data for the areas surrounding Alpharetta. Plus, I've got updated median sales price data, and I'll share some strategies to help you compete in our competitive market. So are you ready? Let's go! Hi friends, I'm Karla Eisele with Keller Williams North Atlanta here in Alpharetta, Georgia. Spring is fast approaching and I'm already talking with sellers who are planning and preparing to put their homes on the market. Typically, sellers prefer to put their home on the market in the spring, which allows them to move during the summer months. That way, they're all settled for when school starts in the fall. Just last week, I met with several sellers and shared the most recent market stats with them. If you're contemplating putting your home on the market this spring, you may want to change that plan just a little. And let's go over why. Currently, that is the taping of this video, looking at single-family homes between the price range of $550,000 to $600,000 in Alpharetta, there's only 4 active listings on the market in that price range. I started in the 550 price range because the median home price in Alpharetta area is $575,000 for the fourth quarter of 2021. Pro tip, if you're a seller in this price range, now would be a great time to take advantage of the market instead of waiting till spring. We'll talk more about inventory later, so stay tuned. The MLS data was taken at the time of taping this video on February 15th, 2022. You're welcome to call me for updated market info if the data is fairly outdated when viewing this video. Let's look at the median price in Alpharetta and the surrounding area. The median price is the middle point for real estate prices. It's the price in the very middle of a data set, with exactly half of the houses priced for less and half priced for more. As of the fourth quarter last year, looking at North Fulton County, which groups areas 23, 24, and 25, seen here, the range is from $500,000 to $700,000 for the median sales price, as compared to the entire Metro Atlanta area median price of $399,000. In North Fulton, area 25, which is the Roswell area, the percent change in median sales price has increased from 10 to 20%, whereas farther north along the Georgia 400 corridor, areas 23 and 24, being Alpharetta, Johns Creek, and Milton, has seen an increase of 20 to 25% in the median sales price. The stats discussed in this video are from the Keller Williams Metro Market Report for single-family homes as of the fourth quarter of 2021. Plus, I have a free download for you which includes the area comparison data across 11 counties throughout the Atlanta metro area, such as median sales price, days on market, percent sales price over original list price, and much more. So you can tap the title of this video to find the link down below and download your very own copy. For my buyers, our current market is fast-paced and you have to be strategic. You'll need to work with a savvy buyer's agent that knows how to navigate a competitive market. So let's go over some strategies to help you compete. First up, buyer financing. You need to be prepared and already have a pre-approval to show your financing is in order. Sellers and listing agents typically prefer when buyers use local lenders because they have a better understanding of property values and the local economy. So in a multiple offer situation, using a respected local lender can tip the scales in your favor. Plus, a savvy buyer's agent will have the local lender call the listing agent to share the strength of their buyer's financing. Another advantage is a local lender answers their phone on weekends and evenings, which is crucial to submitting an offer by the deadline. In our current market, approximately 60% of buyers are experiencing bidding competition, so you will most likely find yourself in a multiple offer situation. with your agent, review the recent comps to see how much over asking homes are selling and the total days on market to determine how fast they're selling. I can tell you right now in the Alpharetta area, average looking homes are selling at 100% of asking price within 10 days. But you know what? My clients don't want an average house. They want a great house. And great homes are selling at 5% up to 10% over list price, and some even higher. And they're selling in a couple of days. That's right, I literally mean within 2 to 3 days. So see why it's so crucial to be prepared in this market. Another great strategy is meeting the seller's needs. It's so important that your agent talk with the listing agent and find out what's most important to the seller. The seller might need a long closing date, or they might need a short closing date. My best advice in a competitive market is you want to accommodate the seller's needs as much as possible. Can you guess what the number one request by sellers in our current market is? Sellers need to stay in the home after closing. This means they become a tenant for a stated period of time. A lot of times this is because they can't move into the home they purchased right away. This is negotiated using a temporary occupancy agreement, which states the number of days they can occupy the home. For an example, let's look at the exhibit. The seller shall have the right to occupy the property for, let's say, 30 days after closing. If the seller doesn't vacate the property by the end of the temporary occupancy period, they would have to compensate you, say, $300 per day. This is your leverage as the buyer. Also, if you're purchasing the home with a loan, the lender will not allow you to go over 60 days. So be aware of that rule. It's best to consult your agent and negotiate a temporary occupancy agreement on a case-by-case basis. Another strategic decision is the length of the due diligence period. A short due diligence period of 5 days or less is typical in a competitive seller's market. For many buyers, due diligence is synonymous with home inspection. And while having a good home and termite inspection and any other necessary inspections for that matter, there are other issues that should be considered during this period. It's important to do your due diligence in all areas. This is the time to research the local schools, inspect the neighborhood, check crime rates, and make sure that you're comfortable with all of these. A due diligence period is a good idea in the event that any inspections don't go as well as you'd hoped, or in the event that you may have changed your mind during due diligence. You're able to terminate the offer and get a full refund of your earnest money deposit as long as you terminate within the due diligence period. Another strategy in a competitive market is using a third-party business to make your offer cash. This may sound new to you, but there are businesses that will back finance buyers with a traditional mortgage and turn them into a cash buyer. Sound too good to be true? Luckily, it's not, but it does require you to pay a fee. But it can help you win in a multiple offer situation. So it's worth considering this as an option in a competitive market. Now let's talk inventory in the Alpharetta, Johns Creek, and Milton areas. Currently, at the recording of this video, there's 137 active single-family homes on the market. Let's take out the new construction, and that leaves just existing homes. There are 79 existing single-family homes on the market. I'm optimistic that our inventory will improve in the coming months. But please remember that we have sellers wanting a temp occupancy. So if your time frame is this summer, like July to move in, you could close on your new home the end of April or end of May, moving your closing up a month or two. Then before you know it, the temp occupancy will be up and you'll be moving into your new home in July. And what about interest rates? There's already been upward activity with rates so far in 2022, much of it due to speculation about what the Fed will do with short-term rates for the rest of this year. Most experts are now calling for the Fed to increase rates 4 to 5 times in 2022 for at least a total of 1%. It's anticipated that the next increase will occur at the Fed meeting in March. Keep in mind, mortgage rates move before the Fed actually does the hiking, so we've already seen mortgage rate increases in the last few months. If you'd like to have a conversation with a respected local lender, contact me and I'll share their info. And finally, let's review the yearly trend analysis for single-family homes in the metro area. As of January 31, 2022, in the entire metro Atlanta market, the inventory is at 1.2 months supply, with a median sales price of $404,000. That's 23% higher than last year. A median of 14 days on market at 22.2%, lower than last year with a 100% list price to sell price ratio at 0.8% higher than last year. The listing inventory is 1.2 months supply, which is flat compared to last year and higher than last month when the listing inventory was 0.9 months. The pending ratio is 65%, 1.4 points up compared to last year, which indicates a fast-paced market. Don't forget to download your free copy of the fourth quarter Metro Market Report, which includes the area comparison data for 11 counties throughout the Atlanta metro area. If you like this video, I have a video spotlighting several subdivisions within the sought-after Windward community in Alpharetta, with various price ranges. You can check it out right up there. Thanks for watching.